Hi gang, this is your favorite magician's red loving Shintoist Regetsu with more interesting information regarding the deep truth about Japan from the mythological times. Today, I will explain about the two bows, two claps, and one bow which we do when we go to a shrine in Japan called Nihai Nihakushu Ippai or Nire Nihakushu Ichire, like I have mentioned in my previous episode on how to pray correctly in Shinto shrines. Please check it out to find out more. The exact origin of why we do this is unknown. Shinto might be the oldest surviving religion in the world, and many of the whys were created before letters were invented. And after letters were invented, any scriptures regarding the whys have been lost during the many civil wars we have had. But we believe we created the modern two bows, two claps, and one bow to establish one official version of the Shinto prayer and to standardize it. Although many regions in Japan still practice their own versions of prayers to this day. Scholars debate that the modern version might have started in the 8th year of Meiji, while some say it was the 9th year of Showa or after World War II. We just aren't 100% certain. The meaning behind the two bows, two claps, one bow is also unknown, and there are many different interpretations. Speaking to many Shinto priests and masters and reading countless books on the subject matter and also phoning the Supreme Shinto headquarters, I have found out there are four possible meanings. Number one, the first bow to show respect and the second bow to show gratitude to the gods. Meaning we bow once for humans like we Japanese do all the time, but twice for the gods. Number two, the first bow to the gods and the second bow to our ancestors. Number three, the first bow to the heavenly gods, Amatsukami, and the second bow to the earth gods, Kunitsukami. Number four, the bow called Re has the same pronunciation with Re, which means spirit, and with Re, which means zero. Same pronunciation, different letters. Hence, they share the same kotodama, and as I bow, I show no intention of will towards you, and this bow or re, and my spirit also re, which is the wakemitama of the gods, and the spirit of the gods also re, are now merging as one, the plus and the minus merging as one to become re or zero. The claps are called kashiwade, as I have mentioned before in my other video. Two claps are called nijikate, and any places which requires you to clap more than four times, like in Izumo for example, is called nagate. We have records stating that the kashiwade has been practiced before the Heian era, which started in 794. Places where they require you to do exactly four claps are places where the previous gods which were worshipped were removed, and the four claps are believed to calm down the spirits and the wrath of those previous gods. Check out which shrines I am talking about by clicking my previous video. The kashiwade is another way of musubi, the connection of the yin and the yang energy, creating once again the unity of the spirits of the gods and us, which makes us one. Remember, in Shinto, the left hand represents divinity and all of the gods, and the right hand humanity. So we always clap with the left hand on a higher level than the right hand, showing that the gods will always be superior to us humans, like this. Then we bring the right hand to the level of the left hand as a symbolism of, in the end, we humans are the wakemitama of the gods, which makes us gods also. And now a lesson on the Japanese culture and language that nobody knows. Another interpretation of the kashiwabe is that in Shinto, left represents the yang energy, which includes masculinity, the sun, the day, etc., represented by our god, Takami Musubi no Kami. The right represents the yin energy, the femininity, the moon, the night, etc., represented by our god, Kami Musubi no Kami. Left in Japanese is hidari, and left hand is hidarite, which comes from the ancient Japanese word hi, or hitarite, or hitarute, hi ga tariterute, which means that the hand that is equal to the sun, or fire,
fire,
or the hand that has sufficient sun, or the sun hand, or the fire hand. Also, since Japan is the country that has our sun goddess, Taiyoshin Amaterasu Omikami-sama as the supreme commander, another interpretation of why we put our right hand lower to the left hand is to show her and the sun respect, admiration, and gratitude. Right in Japanese is migi, and right hand is migite, which comes from the ancient Japanese word mikirite or migirite, which means the hand which perfects or masters the element of water.
H2O!
Or mizu o kiwameru te. The right hand will be the water hand.
Ore datte hiro ni.
So, to everybody who speaks Japanese watching this...
Quite a twist, huh? Bet you didn't see that one coming.
So, when we do the kashiwade, we are joining or doing a musubi of the yang or fire, which can also be pronounced as ka, and yin or water, which can also be pronounced as mi, to create ka-mi. Or Kami, God in Japanese. This is the reason why back then, the names of the boys ended with Hiko, the sun child, now written as Amenigishi Kuninigishi Amatsuhiko Hiko Hono Ninigi no Mikoto Sama is the most famous case, and in modern times, the creator of Jojo no Kimyo na Bouken, Araki Hirohiko. And the girls who worked in the shrines, the priestesses, are called Miko, or Miko, the child of God, or Miko, child of water. The child of water, Miko, or sometimes pronounced Mizuko, means a dead infant or baby in Japanese Buddhism, but not in ancient Shinto, so don't get those two definitions mixed up. And I know what Miko means in Costa Rica. So let's leave the immaturity aside, but how coincidental is it that Miko in Japanese and in Costa Rica are both feminine?
Meow.
And once and only when we unite the yang and the yin, we have a musubi and a new life is born. This is where the Japanese word for sun, musuko, comes from the word musubi no ko, which means the child born from the musubi or unity. The word for daughter is musume or musume in Japanese, and this comes from musubi no me, which means a girl born from musubi. So when we do the kashiwade and create kami or kami, this becomes the kami no oto or God sound. Clapping is something universal, which all cultures do, especially when we want to congratulate someone and to recognize that person, which encourages all of us who receive it. something that all the gods want for all of us. The Kashiwade creates a powerful otodama, another Shinto concept which means the spirit within the sound. Remember, we believe there is spirit in absolutely everything in this universe. I also talked about the other concept of kotodama before. Otodama and kotodama are different, so check out the same episode on the gods which were replaced that I have mentioned before if you want to learn more. Otodama is also something we use to raise our vibration and also to ward off evil spirits or to get the attention of the gods we wish to connect with when we visit them in shrines like with the Kashiwade. After the Kashiwade, we pray, and once we are finished, we bow once, the final Ichire, and we are done. That's it for this episode, gang. Everything that I have just talked about is something not even the typical Japanese know. So thank you so much for watching this. Please like, comment, subscribe, and share this valuable information to your friends on social media to spread the knowledge. I have started Facebook, so please check it out by clicking the link below, and see you all soon. Yasaka!